Agave, high fructose corn syrup, fructose, sucrose, glucose. What does it all mean? Hey there, Soda Pops. I'm Trace. Sweeteners come in many different forms. The health pros and cons are heavily debated. But the important thing is, what happens when you get them into your body? Agave nectar and high fructose corn syrup are two heavy hitters in these debates. So which is worse? Or better? Well, before we go down the which is worse or which one rabbit hole, let's explain how the sweetness affects you. Sugar is a carbohydrate, which means that it's a chain of carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen. Their chemical names usually end in ose. Sucrose, sucralose, glucose, fructose. Glucose is a simple sugar. Plants make it. It's a byproduct of photosynthesis. Fructose is also a simple sugar. It naturally occurs in fruits and is found in honey, sugarcane, corn, obviously, and so on. The real debate comes down to fructose. When you eat a simple sugar like glucose, your body knows what to do with it. That stuff comes from plants, it's natural, your body can actually create it if it wants to. When you eat enough, your brain tells your body, we're good, stop with the sugars. Fructose doesn't do that, it's sneakier. It doesn't tell your body to release insulin, it doesn't tell the brain to cool it with the sugar. This is why we can consume huge amounts of this sweetener. Where glucose can be converted right into energy, fructose has to trek all the way into the liver. By the time it gets there, your body's probably gonna metabolize it into fat instead of turning it into rapid energy. Regular table sugar is 50-50 glucose to fructose. High fructose corn syrup is 45-55 glucose to fructose, which doesn't sound too bad. It's definitely more, but it's not as much as I would have thought. It's called high fructose corn syrup though, because corn syrup itself doesn't contain any fructose naturally. Scientists in the 50s figured out how to add enzymes to the syrup to convert it to 55% fructose. Agave nectar, it can have as much as 90% fructose to 10% glucose. If you're nervous about high fructose corn syrup, by comparison, agave is a frickin' bomb. When agave is marketed, it's usually called healthy and natural, which may be true. Not all agave nectars are produced the same way, but they are all processed in some way. Agave is heated, and then enzymes are added to bring out the right fructose-glucose profile. At the end of the day, it's usually a man-made fructose sweetener like these others. Why is fructose bad, really? It's not. Too much of it is bad, but a little isn't gonna hurt you in the least. The problem is, sugar is in everything these days. Candy bars and milkshakes, sure, but also the beef, the bun, the ketchup, the soda, and the fries at America's fast food places all contain sugar. There is literally sugar in the entire meal. Agave might not be bad on its own either. You can add a lot less to get that same sweet taste from things, but you're basically consuming pure fructose, so go easy on it. If you want to reduce the amount of fructose specifically, don't cut out eating fruit. Fruit contains vitamins and fibers also with fructose, unlike fructose syrup. Don't overdo it, and make sure that you mix your fruits with even more vegetables. In the end, the who's worse battle isn't really settleable. High fructose corn syrup is highly manufactured and nutritionally kind of meh, but agave is also manufactured and similarly nutritionally meh. Sugar should be consumed sparingly regardless, but if you pay attention to the ose, you can't miss it. Make sure you subscribe to DNews, and if you want to see more about how, say, something could have zero calories overall, check out Tara's video right over there. If you have questions about natural or artificial sweeteners, go ahead and leave a comment down below, and thanks for watching.